Sarvakaryogitvam Kriyashakti. Sarvakaryogitvam Kriyashakti. The capacity to assume any form in the universe is Kriyashakti. India is a land known for its spirituality, culture and religious tolerance. Its rich natural resources, panoramic beauty of its landscape, its evergreen tropical forests with their wonderful flora and fauna has attracted over the centuries many famous seafarers, invaders and traders from the distant lands of the East and the West. But in spite of the Mughal invasion and the rule by the British lasting over two centuries, India has preserved its pristine cultural identity and has grown into a multi-religious and multilingual society. The attaining of independence saw India a primarily agricultural economy, transforming itself into a major industrial power with the growth of industries, big and small, in many parts of the country, and the Green Revolution that brought prosperity to the rural people. Many stalwarts and eminent persons have contributed to this silent transformation that has astonished all those who predicted doom to this country after independence. This presentation encapsulates the yeoman services rendered by one such great personality of our times, Arutchelvar Dr.N. Mahalingam, who has created history by his achievements in rural economic reconstruction and alleviation of the sufferings of the poor, downtrodden and the neglected classes for whom the Mahatma laid down his life. Arutchelvar Nachimuttu Mahalingam of Pollachi, held in high esteem and veneration and adored as a living legend by his friends and admirers both within the country and abroad, was the only son of his parents Nachimuttu Gowndar and Rukmani. He was born on March 21st, 1923 in a tradition-bound affluent family of landlords in Somandare Chittur near Pollachi. A proud farmer and a staunch nationalist, Nachimuttu Gowndar led a simple life as a true Gandhian and was respected by his fellowmen for his honesty, integrity and selfless service. He was well known for his compassion, humility and hospitality. He was elected chairman of the Pollachi Municipal Council, a prestigious position which he held with distinction for several years. He is still being remembered with gratitude by the people of Pollachi for bringing electricity to the town, besides developing its infrastructure like roads, water supply and health care facilities. In view of his exposure to public life, Nachimuttu Gowndar broke new ground, giving up his traditional avocation of farming to become an entrepreneur. He started in 1932 the Anamalai Bus Transport Limited, popularly known as ABT, which grew into a major transport organization in the south. It became the nucleus for the corporate and industrial empire. Mr. Nachimuttu Gowndar passed away in 1954 at the age of 52, leaving behind a vast estate and the transport company to be managed by his only son. Although he was born with a silver spoon in his mouth, young Mahalingam never lost himself to ostentatious and pompous living, but remained level-headed with a high sense of responsibility because of the noble traits he inherited from his parents and grandparents. Inspired by the teachings of Mahatma Gandhi and influenced by the writings of Jawaharlal Nehru, he became an embodiment of all good virtues, guided by noble thoughts befitting his status in society. His moral and spiritual upbringing under the care of his disciplinarian father, whom he respected and revered, molded his character and helped him grow into a powerful personality. And his activities were marked by simple living and high thinking. Since he grew up at a time when the freedom struggle was at its zenith, he developed an insatiable urge to enter politics. But his father would not allow him to think of politics until he completed his education. As a dutiful son, Mahalingam obeyed the commands of his father and devoted his attention to his education. He graduated in physics from the Loyola College in Madras and pursued his postgraduate education in mechanical engineering at the Government College of Engineering, Guindy. He married his uncle's daughter, Mariammal, in 1945, as desired by his father, and returned to Pollachi to look after the transport business. After completing his studies, he entered politics and became the convener of the Coimbatore District Youth Congress in 1949, which marked the beginning of his political career. NM, as he was affectionately called by everyone, Mahalingam got elected to the Madras State Assembly on a Congress ticket from the Pollachi constituency in 1952 with the blessings and active support of his father. The 15 years which he served as a member of the state legislature was a momentous period in the history of Tamil Nadu that witnessed not only its phenomenal success in economic development among the states in India, but also the rise and fall of the Congress party. Since his father passed away in the early stages of his political career, Mahalingam had to fend for himself, apportioning his time between politics and his family transport business, which he did with remarkable alacrity and shrewdness to succeed in both with his vision, maturity, education, training and determination. He meticulously ensured that at no time during his term of office, his political status ever influenced his business fortunes. He was a highly principled man and was forthright in expressing his views boldly and frankly, as he considered his loyalty to the party more important than its leaders and detested playing opportunistic politics. He belonged to that rare breed of politicians to whom politics without ethics had no meaning, and shunned practicing politics as a profession for amassing personal wealth, as he believed that his entry into politics was a God-given opportunity to serve the nation and its people. As an elected representative, he nursed his constituency well and worked relentlessly for the development of the Pollachi region. He was largely instrumental for the planning and execution of the interstate multipurpose Parambikulam RER project, which has helped to irrigate over 400,000 acres of semi-arid dry land and brought succor to over 500,000 families who depended on agriculture for their livelihood. Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru, who commissioned this project, lauded the achievements of Mahalingam and paid glowing tributes to the selfless service and the constructive role he played as a legislator. What Mr. Mahalingam did for his constituency during his 15-year term in office as an MLA remains unmatched till this day. He succeeded in bringing about a big transformation in the life of the people of his constituency by fostering development of rural industries, power projects, industrial estates and housing colonies, keeping the elimination of poverty, unemployment and empowerment of the poor as his chief goals in life. An incisive thinker and planner, Mr. Mahalingam made the assembly proceedings lively by his constructive criticisms of government policies and thought-provoking ideas and views on various subjects and issues which were far ahead of times and came as a stunning and startling revelation to many in both the Treasury and opposition benches. Needless to mention, the members heard his speeches in the legislature with rapt attention, as his thinking on various matters were both innovative and extraordinary at that point of time. As a visionary, he could foresee developments of the future and offer pragmatic suggestions to tackle problems that might arise. His pronouncements in politics were often prophetic, Typical of his Gandhian thinking, Mr. Mahalingam touched on the evils of over-industrialization and modernization and pleaded for the development of small-scale rural industries on the Japanese model. Expansion of irrigation in the state was his magnificent obsession that made him work for the execution of the Parambikulam and RDR project. He put up a strong case for interlinking Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Pennar and Kaveri rivers and advocated a self-finance scheme to generate funds required for its implementation. He pointed out that if the scheme was implemented, the entire active population in this region would get full employment and the social problems of the people living in the drought-prone regions of Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh and parts of Tamil Nadu would vanish. He renounced the field of politics in 1969, which came as a blessing in disguise and a godsend to his family, which needed his full involvement in its transport business. It marked the beginning of a glorious chapter in the life of Mahalingam. Mr. Mahalingam's eminence as an entrepreneur par excellence started blossoming as he commenced working full-time for the Sakti group of companies. The secret of Mahalingam's success as an entrepreneur lay in his identifying talented professionals both from within the family circle and outside for delegation of powers and administrative responsibilities. He also enjoyed the benefit of securing the dedicated services of a band of loyal lieutenants who grew with him. As an engineer who had access to modern technology, M.M. could have made a big fortune for himself had he gone the high-tech way. But he preferred the Gandhian route of service to humanity by setting up industries in rural areas to tackle the formidable problem of poverty and unemployment, which were the root cause and bane of India's economic progress. Within a short span of two decades, commencing 1957, NM set up as many as 20 public limited companies engaged in the manufacture of sugar, textiles, synthetic gems, soft drinks, soya, tea, milk and foundry products, and service industries in tire retreading, transport of goods, sale of automobile and automobile parts. A shrewd business strategist as he was, Mr. Mahalingam, who perceived the inevitability of the nationalization of the road transport sector, started the ABT Parcel Service Limited in 1964, which has emerged as a major transport company in the country. Sakti's income soared as it became a household name in the south, and by 1997 the Sakti Group came to be ranked among the top 100 family companies in India. As a business tycoon of a different order, although all his ventures were close to his heart, Sakti Sugars Limited, one of India's biggest sugar manufacturing enterprises, became the jewel in his crown, as it was a rare blend of his business acumen and social philosophy. NM found in the setting up of the agro-based industry immense potential for rapid agricultural and rural development, farmers' induction into scientific farming to increase productivity and tremendous scope for providing the much-needed healthcare services to the rural poor. He set up his first sugar plant in Shaktinagar near Bhavani in Erode district with an initial crushing capacity of 1,250 tons per day and organized the farmers in the villages within a radius of 50 kilometers by offering them incentives to raise sugarcane. He proved with the help of sugarcane scientists that sugarcane, which was still then considered a seasonal crop, could be raised throughout the year by cultivating suitable high-yielding varieties, and demonstrated that cane crushing could be done for 300 days in a year, providing continuous employment and earnings to farmers. As a spillover, a large number of villages in the region were electrified and provided with roads and transport services, leading to prosperity in rural homes. The methane gas and the distillery waste, which were available as byproducts, were utilized as fuel in the kitchen, and for the production of press mud compost and organic manure used widely in farming. As a benign and model employer, NM shared his profits with the community that helped his growth. Mr. Mahalingam initiated the voluntary health service project that encouraged village adoption by industries, offering them tax incentives. Although the succeeding government withdrew the scheme, casting a heavy burden on the industry, Mr. Mahalingam chose to continue it in the larger interests of the suffering humanity. Similar thinking also resulted in Mr. Mahalingam launching the Shakti Soya Processing Complex in Pollachi to help the farming community and provide the much needed nutritional support to the masses by promoting the use of soya in food preparations. It was a remarkable feat that despite his preoccupation in politics and business, Mr. Mahalingam followed the footsteps of his father in taking care of a big joint family. True to the general saying that behind every successful man there is a successful woman, NM had in his wife Mariammar a dutiful and loving companion, an expert in home management, and well trained in a joint family setup right from her childhood. Despite her rural background, Mariammar Mahalingam managed the household affairs with remarkable efficiency and brought up their children, daughter Karunambar and sons Manikkam, Balasubramanyam and Srinivasan, in keeping with the family traditions. An erudite scholar and a versatile genius, Mr. Mahalingam was a multifaceted personality who evinced keen interest in the study of almost all subjects on earth, from modern science to philosophy, spirituality and religion, architecture, agriculture, Tamil literature, astronomy, economics, medicine, education and music. It was his great teacher, Mr. K.P. Madhavan Pillai, who introduced Mahalingam to the habit of good reading by presenting him with numerous books. Mr. K.P. Madhavan Pillai was a source of great inspiration and was instrumental in molding Mahalingam. This habit of reading developed in the childhood translated Mahalingam into an ardent lover of literature. As an old-timer rooted in Indian culture, he showed keen interest in the Indian systems of medicine, Ayurveda and Siddha. He is a strict vegetarian, wears only khadi and leads a simple life. Mr. Mahalingam, a voracious reader of books, derives immense pleasure in distributing them free to his friends and visitors so that they could also enjoy their reading and improve their knowledge. His interest is in the study of astronomy, cosmology, parapsychology, Egyptology, ufology and archaeology. Mr. Mahalingam is a lover of arts and sports. Besides being a good chess player himself, he supported all sportsmen and sports organizations. In order to promote chess, he instituted awards to outstanding players. The credit for spotting the talent in Vishwanathan Anand, who became the world chess champion in 2000, should go to Mr. Mahalingam, the then president of the Tamil Nadu Chess Federation. As a philanthropist known for his generosity, Mr. Mahalingam helped researchers and scholars and made liberal donations for temple construction and renovation in all parts of the country, and for the propagation of vegetarianism and spiritualism. He was also a connoisseur of music and a patron of fine arts and culture. Despite his love for Tamil, Mr. Mahalingam developed keen interest in the study of Sanskrit right from his school days and championed its cause as an official language of the country. He has authored a number of books in Tamil and English, besides contributing articles to all the national newspapers in the country on various subjects of public interest. NM was a builder of institutions and a leading educationist. He founded several engineering and arts and science colleges and polytechnics providing education with a spiritual base, as he always believed that education without ethics and moral values will be of no avail. Above all his materialistic achievements, what really contributed to his rise in public esteem is his spiritual disposition, which has made him a karma yogi, highly religious but secular in his outlook. He is known across the world for his moral convictions. Participating in the World Conference on Religion and Peace held in Jordan in 1999, Mr. Mahalingam made a forceful plea to leaders of all religions to prevail upon their followers to get together and offer prayers collectively to pave the way for universal brotherhood. This octogenarian, who's quite agile and active in public life, is a staunch follower of the Sanmarga philosophy propounded by the great savant Sri Ramalinga Adigalar, popularly known as Vallalar. Vallalar is a shining example of a seer who unified religion and science by his treatise on space and matter. By giving a spiritual dimension to particles that make up all matter around us. Mr. Mahalingam has undertaken the task of popularizing the concept of Jyoti worship, or the worship of the light, advocated by Vallalar and practiced by almost all the religions in the world. His spiritual inclination and philosophic outlook brought him closer to Vedantic scholars. The efforts MM took in building the ashram complex of Tattvajnani Vedatri Maharishi in Aliyar at the foot of the Western Ghats near Pollachi is one of the biggest contributions he has made for the propagation of Jnana Marg. It is in the fitness of things that Mahalingam, who has devoted his life for the propagation of spiritual and ethical values, has been honored by leaders of all faiths. He was conferred the Ramanujar Award by the Center for the Research of Alwar's Literature in 2000 AD, the honorary degree of Doctor of Laws by the Bharatiyar University in 1984, the title Aram Valarkum Annal by Sri Shankaracharya of Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham, Arutchelvar by Sri Kripananda Variyar, Jnana Dana Vallal by Tavatiru Sundara Swamigal of Kaumara Matalayam, Shivam Perukkum Sealer by the head of the Dharmapuram Adinam, Dharma Ratnakara by Sri 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 Balagangadhara Mahanatha Swamigal of Adi Chunchanagiri Mutt in Karnataka, in appreciation of his services in the field of religion and philosophy. Tamil Chemmal by Tamil Nadu Kalai Ilakkiya Perumandram, Vibrant Indian by Developers India Chennai, Muttamil Sevaratnam again by His Holiness Kanchi Jagatguru Sri Shankaracharya Swamigal in the year 2003. The Tamil Nadu government appointed him as a member of the State Planning Commission in the 70s and 80s. What with the accolades he has received so far for his exemplary services to the country, this octogenarian, who is working round the clock, attending to his public engagements, feels that he has yet to go a long way to fulfill his mission in life. When asked about his next mission by the President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, during his personal meeting with Dr. NM, he replied, full of indomitable energy, zeal and dynamism, that he would like to research on the Tamil scripts used about 5,000 years ago. No wonder the President was spellbound, for the answer was from Dr. NM at the age of 80. Rightly said, visionaries don't age. Humble, down to earth, and soft spoken, but very aggressive when it comes to quality and hard work, all those who know Dr. Mahalingam would remember his sympathy, humanity, and compassion. Numerous people are beneficiaries of his munificence and benevolence. He is a pious individual who sees God in every aspect of nature. Always a distinct personality, Arutchelvar Dr. N. Mahalingam stands apart. For he is not only a successful industrialist of modern India, but also a prosperous farmer, an ardent educationist, a respected nationalist, a zealous traveler, a prolific writer, an unrivaled collector of books, a philanthropist, a spiritualist, a sportsman, a man of letters, and the recipient of innumerable titles and awards. Dr. Mahalingam, an exceptional genius, a versatile personality, the role model of the century, and a leader for the younger generation to emulate. Dr. Mahalingam, truly a living legend.